quickly go to the issue of criminal pastors. We have a very bothering issue, and I want to ask your opinion about it. In the last 4 or 5 years now, one of Nigeria's famous man of God, and maybe gifted man of God, that's Reverend King, has been sentenced to death, and he's been transferred from one prison to the other, from Lagos to Kaduna to different prisons. And most of the prisons he's been transferred to, we learned that he will sleep with women, maybe impregnate some, start, you know, do everything. Then his member will go there to hold him, they will transfer him to another prison until his case was determined at the highest court and was sentenced to death. And there are a lot of others like that, criminally minded men of God, that have been sentenced to death. So, is it right for the governor of the state to append his signature for them to go and be, you know, killed? I mean, or is it good that they should just leave them? Because Reverend King was accused of pouring hot water and petrol upon one of his members because he said she was sleeping with a junior member. And he burnt her alive and beat some other people, naked them for...
Who gave him authority to kill?
No, as a man of God, as their pastor, you know, and when he's preaching in the church, people cannot even go out. You have to shit on the table. If you have been under nature call, you shit or you urinate there. If he's coming to the church, you cannot go out, you cannot come in, they'll beat you. Your car cannot even move. Now this man is in jail and been sentenced for the past 5 years now. Sir, do we release him from prison so that he can continue his work of God in Ajao Estate? Or, you know, what do we do?
My brother, what did you people call God?
Now, see, the work of God, that's why I say, sir.
Which work did God send him?
I mean, to capture people in his church.
Where?
Manage.
Somebody killed his member.
He punished him.
He said, thou shalt not kill. Don't argue.
Yes, sir.
Thou shalt not kill.
Okay, sir.
Did Nigeria want to manufacture the new Bible?
I don't think so, sir.
But the way you are talking, it looks as if they've given you money to go and manipulate the Bible. When you look at the book of Joshua, Joshua 4, Joshua 5 and 6,
okay, sir.
It said, for Achan putting his hand into the treasury, he said, take stone and kill all his own family and Achan. They ought to have killed him for so long. They should sign. They should kill him.
Oh, you mean the governor Ambode?
Yes, because it's only we have all the female governor. Ambode is a woman. Fashola, it happened in the regime of Fashola.
Okay.
Yeah, Fashola is what? He's a lawyer. But he didn't know what he's doing. He's a baby lawyer. Even the son they gave to him, Tinubu bought it for him. How many cases has he won before he became a minister? How many cases has he won as a lawyer? My brother, if this one happened in America, it will not take 3 months.
You made a ranking?
Yes, they will put him on the bed.
No, he just bought
They will on. Put him on the electrocuted bed, okay, and finish him. They should kill them. That will stand as a deterrent to what? To other person. When you look at the book of Exodus 4, Exodus 5, and Exodus 6, even in Exodus 1, verse 10, he said, don't allow us to allow these Israelites to be having freely all these boys they are giving back to.
In case of war, they
may
join
our enemy.
In order to fight against
them, kill their son at bat. It's in the Bible. If you take machete to kill people, person, they should use the machete back on you. You get what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
He's using money to settle some people.
I mean that
we're supposed not to be even the same crime committed by Oyenusi. The same crime committed by Anini and Yamu. It's the same. That's the same crime. He's not fit to live amongst human beings again. Look at in America.
No, it's
sad. If somebody is phobia, or I think, what do they call it?
Yeah,
if you like sleeping with
pedophile.
If you are pedophile or anything, they won't allow you freedom.
Among you, what I mean?
Amongst the free citizens. Because automatically you have already made the path you wanted to follow. They don't supposed to even spare his life. Even the Evans, they are dragging too much on the case of Evans. So evidence are there already.
No, he's a professional kidnapper, sir.
He cannot be a professional kidnapper.
Okay.
Because the fact the parents were too loose. He said, train your children. When you now get to the adult stage,
it will give you peace.
It will give you peace. But see what Evans and everything is doing.
He's giving his father.
What he did was what this man did in those this fellas that work with Ranini.
Okay.
There's another Felix.
The police officer?
No, no, no. Even Iyamu and all this. Edina, they kill all of them. Look at Mama Vasta. Babangida never waste time. You know what I'm saying? They should please, after watching this video, they should sign and clear the place.
That's the Reverend King.
Yes, they should clear all of them.
And people like that?
You see, he can't come back to be normal human being again. You have already, you took life.
No, he was sleeping.
It's not by accident.
Yes.
If it's by accident, it's another thing.
Yeah.
But this one, you...
They put petrol on her and just put fire on her.
Put fire on somebody.
Somebody to punish her, sir. For sleeping, I think it's his former girlfriend, so he's now slept with a junior member.
So?
And that's a very relegated...
And himself is a fornicator. So it's not clean of, it's not clean of what he's doing.
He's helping them, sir.
So it's not helping them. It's happening even in Abule, this time some time ago.
Yes, sir.
That's in the month of May and June. A professional pastor, a redeemed pastor, was sleeping with three maids.
Jesus Christ.
His wife making the number four. Sir, he said, if your eyes want to make you commit adult sin, he said, remove it. In the process that I wanted to help them to get education, you kept them under your roof. And you are maltreating and manipulating, doing all those rubbish to them. Not until the wife girl decided to go and report in the police station that some people in the street are molesting my husband, accusing him of my husband, or what my husband did not do. Then they now clap on his face and say, let's go to the police station. What you did not know all day, we explain everything to you.
Hmm.
And when they scrutinized those three ladies, they confessed.
Daddy,
even sleeping. The other one said that there was a day when daddy was even making love with one. I accidentally opened the door. Daddy beckoned on me that, oh yeah, come and sleep again. A redeemer. A redeemer.
My God.
They should go and find out in Sango.
My God.
They should go to police station in Sango to go and find out.
Sir, but what is the reason for all this? If you open the paper today, you see pastors sleeping with
children. Even in redeem, in a Catholic church, the same thing. When you look at the Catholic people, there are some of the Reverend Father. There is a Reverend Father here. In this Alakuko area here around Abuleroko. They posted him down here, not knowing that he has a wife and three children.
Jesus Christ. In the east.
In the east. And they traced and traced until the woman got here to say, are you here? Before the church came. He ran away. And I've met five of them again in New York. In an Igbo Reverend Father carrying Chioma and all these ladies down to New York, getting them a visa, keep them there. Whenever they said they are going on leave, they will be putting on Nika, making love to all these people. I liberated four out of the eight I found that day.
Mm.
And they now get the original husband today.
Mm.
They use the Catholic to get them visa. On the Catholic letterhead.
But what is wrong, sir? What is going on?
There is nothing wrong. They forced them to that job. You know, I told you somebody who wanted to trek from here to Europe through the desert. We never know what he's going to meet on the way. It's not like somebody who said he's a pastor whom the Lord did not call. You remember in the book of 1 Samuel? 1 Samuel 3, 1 Samuel 4, then 1 Samuel 8 and 9, and 1 Samuel 10. He said he saw among the prophet. He said, why is he prophesying? Then he now said, you remember when the Lord called Samuel? You say you see the Bible. And that was what made him to have a good testimony. In the book of 1 Samuel 12, 1 to 10.
That's crazy.
He said, Kete kete tani mugbe, agmuto tani mugba. Taleni no to jekini to yomi. To nisogwe, mo yonle nuri. And that's the king I wanted to set for you, is it? And that man was going in his old age. 1 Samuel 12, 1 to 10. Then when you look at the enthronement of David, in the book of First Samuel 16 and 15, he said, do you have any other child that is not here? He said, yes, I have one. And the name is David. He said, I will not sit down until what?
That David comes.
Because the power, the anointing of him. And they use the animal horn to put
anointing.
The oil, anointing. Not the one of this feed bottle and granite oil. that the court here put it on Adebo, put it on Adebo, you put it on Oyedepo. He said it's anointing.
Samuel said to Saul, I am the one who the Lord sent to anoint you king of his people Israel. Now listen to what the Lord Almighty says. He's going to punish the people of Amalek because their ancestors opposed the Israelites when they were coming from Egypt. Go and attack the Amalekites and completely destroy everything they have done. Don't leave a thing. Kill all the men, women, children, and babies. The cattle, sheep, camel, and donkey. Saul called his forces together and inspected them at Talem. There were 200,000 soldiers from the Israel and 10,000 from Judah. Then he and his men went to the city of Amalek and waited in ambush in a dry riverbed. He sent a warning to the Canaanites, a people whose ancestors had been kind to the Israelites.
That's okay. That's okay, sir.
That's quite interesting.
Yes, sir.